Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Waa barnaamij gaar ah ee gudoonka waxbarashada dugsiyada dadweynaha Minneapolis iyo kormeeraha guud ee dugsiyada dadweynaha Minneapolis Dr. Benedia Johnson ay ugu talagaleen maalinta xuska walaalkeen marxuum Allah u naxariistay Hussein Samatar oo isagu ahaa gudoonka waxbarashada dugsiyada dadweynaha Minneapolis iyo asaasihii iyo fuliyaha sare ee shirkadda ABC goobta waxaa ka soo qayb galay dadweyne aad u fara badan oo iyagu ka kala duwan dhinacyo wala badan waxaa ka mid ahaa duqa magaalada Arti Reybak oo isagu ah saaxiib ay aad iyo aad isugu dheer yihiin Hussein Samatar oo run ahaantii ku nooxnooxsaday kaalinta uu meelaha kala duwan haddii noqon lahayd maktabadaha haddii ay noqon lahayd Wells Fargo ADC iyo Boardba Hussein uu ka soo qaatay muddadii uu noolaa dadka kala duwan ee iyagu ka hadlay madasha xafladda ayaa aad u tilmaamay astaamaha hoggaamiyenimo oo caan ku ahaa walaalkeen Hussein Samatar. Waxa ay tilmaameen in uu aad iyo aad ugu dadaali jiray si dadka immigrantka ah ama iyagu muhaajiriinta ee dalkan yimid ay u gaari lahaayeen isku filaansho dhaqaale isla markaasna ubadkoodu ay wax u baran lahaayeen si ay mustaqbalka iyagu isu anfacaan. Dhammaan waxay wada galeen inuu lahaa astaamaha hoggaamiyenimo ee loo baahan yahay haddii qofku uu doonayo inuu guulaysto. Ugu dambeyntii, marxuum Hussein Samatar ilaahay ha u naxariisto jannadii firdowsana ha ka waraabiyo eheladiisii, qaraabadiisii, cashiiradiisii, ubadkiisa, afadiisa iyo asxaabtiisa dunida tacaladeeda ku noolna samir iyo iimaan ha ka siiye. Waxaa guud ahaantood ay tilmaameen in uu u dejiyey taariikh nololeed ay ku dareen karaan bulshada ka dambeysa. Waxay kaloo tilmaameen inay muhiim tahay in aan halgankiisii meeshii uu ku dambeeyey aan ka sii qaadno islabsi mustaqbalka innaga iyo ubadkeennaba aan uga sabata baxno dhibaatooyinka jira. Barnaamijka ayaa badidiisa ku socon doonaa afka Ingiriisiga isla markaasna ay daadihinaysaa kormeeraha guud ee dugsiyada dadweynaha Minneapolis Dr. Benedia Johnson sidaa iyo daawasho wacan. Wassalaamu calaykum waraxmatullaahi wabarakaatu.
All for being here today. Before we start the program, the legacy program, in honor of Hussein Samatar, we have a short video that we'd like to see of him and some of his work that he's done.
There is a decent ELL plan. And the missing link was the community link. And this is today, for me, I will tell my board members, I will also tell the superintendent, this is starting to shape out to be from your own input. But I'm just going to tell you, when I meet that community members who speak Spanish, or a mom, or others, they really saying that, you know, those Somalis are organized. They are really organized. What are they doing? You know, how can we learn from lately? This was my honor. It was not yours. It was my honor to be here as a board, as a new board member. And the former.
Thank you to them for putting together that video and giving us opportunity to hear from Director Samatar himself. And I just want, as you all know, this has been a very difficult week for the MPS school community. And we appreciate you coming out tonight to celebrate the legacy of Director Samatar. It's been really tough for all of us. And before I begin my comments, I would like to say, ask Mayor Ryback to come forward, because I know he has a couple words to say, and he also has something for the family.
Thank you, Superintendent, everyone from the school, for putting together this wonderful event. I think the community needs and deserves the opportunity to honor Hussein. In my day job, I unfortunately have the responsibility of often being around death, and sadly you learn how to deal with that, but I have to be really blunt with you and say that the loss of Hussein has hit me personally harder than almost any I can remember in a long, long time. And it isn't because I don't grieve everyone in this city. It's in large part because maybe, like some of you, I allowed myself to be fooled into thinking that Hussein was getting better, and largely more than anything, because the loss of Hussein is so, so deep, and he is so irreplaceable. I've thought a lot about that word irreplaceable, though, in the time since then, and tried to think about what can we replace? How do we fill a vacuum with someone like Hussein? It is not an easy thing to do at all, nor should it be. But I have decided that what is best, at least in my case, is to think about when I go around this city, to really recognize that parts of Hussein remain with us. I will never be able to go into the Franklin Library without thinking that this is the place that opened its doors in this remarkable, generous community to a man who came from across the globe and helped him learn English, helped him master the intricacies of business here, and helped launch him into success at Wells Fargo. I will never be able to go to Safari Express or the many other businesses in this community, the dress shop and the souk and Blaisdell and 60 others in the city, without thinking of Hussein, because he's the person who helped us figure out how to do that finance. I will not be able to look at that dais. There's many wonderful people, bless you, who will be up there without seeing Hussein up there. But I'll see his presence when there's somebody who makes an extremely wise statement, something that may be out of the box, something that may be sometimes uncomfortable, but more than anything else, it's clear that he's focused on children. And I think in my own life, I will think very much of Hussein whenever I look for the wisdom in a community that comes from someone whose experience has been so very difficult, an incredibly long road, and yet his life's work became not about retracing that road, but building another for someone else. Hussein is a person who will always, always live with me. And I think with so many others, he will not be replaceable, but there are so many pieces of Hussein throughout our community that I hope we recognize many years from now that the beginning of understanding Hussein only began today. So I want to thank you for doing that, and to thank the family so much for all your work.
Thank you, Mayor. Again, I want to welcome all of you to this memorial service and honoring the legacy and life of Hussein Samatar. First of all, I just want to say, as you probably all know, he was a board member, but he was also a loving father and friend and colleague to many. And the one thing that I thought about as I was thinking about Hussein and his journey is that he was put on earth for a purpose, and he will also, he left a legacy for us to follow. He left a roadmap for us to follow in the years to come. So that's his legacy to us, and it's up to us as individuals to see our role and part in that moving forward. And I want to make sure that we are here today to think about the good times that we had with him and that strong legacy that he left with us. And I also want to make sure that I make a couple of statements about today's program so that people know there are many people who would want to speak, but we want to make sure that we have quite a few people on the program. We keep it to 1 to 2 minutes each. And next, we have Kenneth Evan, who's going to come up and talk about time and about his experience and with Director Samatar. Oh, Kenneth. I'm like, I know that name.
Good afternoon. It's really an honor to be asked to come and speak today, and an honor to speak at the memorial of such a great man, Hussein Samatar. I feel a little bit weird being up here today because I unfortunately did not have the privilege of getting to know Hussein Samatar directly. I came to a bunch of school board meetings at the beginning of the year, and I heard about his passion, and I heard his vision for MPS, which will be talked about later, but I didn't have a real relationship with him. However, I am here today because I did have the privilege to teach Haroon Samatar this summer at Learning Works, and I really remember this one assignment that I gave Haroon and his class this summer at Learning Works, which was to speak about your role model. And all the students gave fantastic speeches, and they were all great, and they worked really hard on them. But Haroon's really stuck with me, even to this day, because first of all, he picked his dad as his role model. And at that age, I thought that was amazing, because it really spoke to the type of man that Hussein was. But the other reason why it really stuck with me was because of the way he conveyed his message. He had so much, he has so much pride in his father, and he has so much joy when he speaks about him. And it was really just amazing to hear the way that Haroon spoke, the way that you spoke about all of his accomplishments, and the way that you spoke about the man that he was at home. It was great to hear. And I think it speaks volumes to the type of person that Hussein Samatar was. It really shows, because it's one thing for all of us as a community to know and admire Hussein Samatar from a distance, but for someone up close and personal to be able to see that every single day behind closed doors and not take that for granted, I believe says more about Hussein Samatar than any other person can. And so I think Hussein, even though I didn't know Hussein directly, he left a mark on me because I was fortunate enough to know Haroon this summer and hear him speak about his father. And I think that's how Hussein's legacy will continue to live on in this community, because the people that were close to him will leave a mark on others because of the mark that he left on those that were close to him. So thank you.
Next we have Scott Fleming, and we'll ask Idol Hassan and Hawa Muhammad to also be prepared to come in order. So Scott Fleming first, and then Idol, and then Hawa.
Good afternoon. My name is Scott Fleming. I'm the director of the Office of Equity and Community Engagement at the Blake School. I'm honored to be here on behalf of our school, where Hussein was a former trustee and who was a current parent of two Blake students. Hussein used to greet me with, "Ah, Mr. Scott, so good to see you," and then smile his radiant, enveloping smile. I usually followed with, "Ah, the Mamule," which my Somali friends tell me means the big chief. And indeed he was. I already miss him very much. Hussein and I spoke often about Learning Works, a collaboration between Blake and the Minneapolis Public Schools, which is now in its 14th year. It was very dear to Hussein's heart. Each summer and every other Saturday during the school year, Learning Works offers an academic enrichment program for high potential, highly motivated middle school students from MPS, supporting them on their path to college. The students come from 18 different MPS middle schools, representing every neighborhood and every story in the city. You've heard how Learning Works has had a positive impact on Hussein's son Haroon from Kenneth Ibn, and it seems like that was very much reciprocal too, how much Haroon impacted Kenneth. And Hussein, in turn, was a Learning Works champion. At the 2011 Learning Works graduation, I watched in admiration as Hussein led our graduates into the ceremony and delivered a rousing, eloquent keynote speech, drawing upon the themes of resiliency and fortitude that he modeled in his own life. He knew how to speak to young people, appealing to their youthful idealism and merging it with his own. Hussein was a Learning Works champion because it appealed to him on so many levels. As a person who brokered deals that brought people and companies together across real differences, Hussein loved public-private partnership aspect. Two big educational institutions using their shared mission to deliver academic excellence in a caring community in order to develop global citizens. I remember one night last fall sitting with Hussein at one of Hanad's football games, listening to him talk about how much he loved the opportunity that Learning Works offers students to get out beyond their building and their neighborhood to connect deeply with students from all over the city. I recently heard from a young Somali woman who went to Learning Works and graduated from South High and is now a Wallen scholar at Hamline. As I listened to her talk about the impact of Learning Works on her family, I immediately thought of Hussein and how she personified his hopes for his own children, for the Somali community, and for every student in Minneapolis Public Schools. On behalf of the Blake community, I want to close by saying how committed we are to honoring Hussein and his legacy by serving the Samatar family to the best of our ability, and by keeping the Learning Works flame burning brightly as an expression of our highest aspirations for educating students at MPS and at Blake. Thank you.
Actually, I was told to talk about what I knew about Hussein, but the agenda says that the work that he's done with Seward families. Actually, he did support us, as I am a parent of Seward, but today I'm here to talk about what I knew Hussein. As we all gather here to give thanks and celebrate the life of Hussein, at one point or another, we all had encountered with Hussein, whether personal, business, or work-related. Hussein was caring, humble, and also an inspirational person. Personally, I knew Hussein for almost 16 years. He was my friend and also my mentor during my school, college. He advised me regarding my career, encouraged me to never give up with my schooling. For example, when I was attending Minneapolis Community College, I was having a difficulty with my financial accounting class. Hussein always encouraged me to never give up. He was always there for me whenever I need him. He helped me with my work and my projects to at least be there for me. Hussein was that kind of person. When he's through my membership, through my mentorship, I was able to complete my bachelor degree, and also I'm on my way to achieving my MBA in healthcare. Hussein was passionate about education and also loved to help others. Whenever I heard this quote, the purpose of education is to replace an empty mind with an open one, by Malcolm Forbes. It truly reminded me Hussein's passion about education. Hussein was a loving father, a role model to his children, and also a great husband to Uba. As they say, behind every successful man is a great woman behind. Well, Uba was that great woman. She was Hussein's biggest cheerleader, always there to support and also encourage him along the way. Uba, not only she lost a husband, but also she lost her best friend. Today I ask that everyone to continue to remember Uba in their prayers as she finds the strength to carry on and raise her children. Please remember the rest of the family, they have lost someone special, a father, a son, a brother, uncle, and a friend. Hussein was a great leader to his family, a voice for our community, and also he was a great member of the Board of Education. When a leader passes on, it's important that we remember him and encourage others to follow his legacy. I pray and hope that others will see his determination, his encouragement, and also inspired to follow his footsteps, because he certainly was a great man to look up to. May Allah grant him to Jannah. May Allah bless his family with sabr, patience during these difficult times. Amen.
In the name of Allah, in the name of God, most gracious, most merciful, guests of honors, teachers, students, fellow parents, ladies and gentlemen, I am greatly honored to have the opportunity to address this special event. My name is Hawa Mohammed. I am one of the parents from Somalia who live in twin cities and children stay at Minneapolis Public School, Special School, which Hussein was a parent. Hussein was a scholar who had high vision for education, a leader who was role model, a father, a good friend who had a passion for education and development of children and families. He was a parent who encouraged children to be educated, to have a prosperous future. Hussein has left a gap with the community, in the community, which can be felt among the community who spoke their same language, especially immigrants, parents, and mother, who took their children to school and never knew their rights. Hussein believes that ignorance is darkness, and the darkness is without light, and without light is without life. The Somali community who come to this country without knowing the language culture, and education, Mr. Hussein Samatar was the vocal leader. And we heard from him activities, companies, and uniting and importance of standing together as a community.
يروح برشاد حسين هو الكري وهليه هرموه نوه لميه وهي جنبوها هميلا وعانينا كانوا هيك سنجيري حيبت الصومالي دوه لتكن رحدي يروح برشاد حسين هو الكري وهليه هرموه نوه لميه وهي جنبوها حميدة وعنينا نقار نوهوس هادي تشيري لما هي الماما التاريخ ذواها ارتا لما هي الماما التاريخ ذواها ارتا وعينا نيك سناه كونوهوس هادي تشيري جليل كو يا سراج تكي سراب آمين بك آمين
Again, I am Bernadia Johnson, Superintendent of Schools, and I want to make sure that you know that this is a commitment from the board and myself to make sure that we have a time to honor Director Samatar, just so you know that our board members are here as well. And we've talked about Hussein's personal impact, and next we will talk about his values, and we have several people who want to comment on that. And I'm going to ask people to come in the order which I call your name: Muhammad Noor, Raha Wasame, Al Flowers, Ilhan Omar, and Shonda Smith Baker.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Awalu Bismillah. Alhamdulillah. My name is Raha Wasame. My condolences goes out to Raximahu Hussein Samatar's loved ones, families, friends, co-workers, and the community at large. I'm very sure so much he touched their lives. I know Hussein started working with him side by side, Somali community issues, and the other community in large. He never considered only Somali community because always he said to me, we cannot survive alone unless we have other community strong together. And that's wisdom that I remember. He never called me my name. He used to call me sister, which is a bio. What's new today? That's what he used to say, and I'm gonna miss that. I used to go anytime challenging him, and he challenges me about the issues going on with the community at large. And that's one thing that I'm not sure if I have another Hussein could feel his position to do that for me. And I have that confidence. No matter the time and issue, is something that we understand each other and go in the best direction we think it would be best to the community in Minnesota. Also out to Europe. He didn't touch only in North America, also in Europe. To conclude my long story, I'm kind of shocked. He used to tilt that way and say, "Hey, boy, today we have something." And that's something that he's humble to listen carefully when I try to address it. I don't have it anymore, but I pray. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease the sorrow and the anxiety those who missed the most. Rahimullah, Hussein Samatar, his family, friends, co-workers, neighbors, and the community at large. May he subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us our sins and grant us to highest Jannah, which is heaven. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heal the sick, shelter the homeless, feed the hunger, bless those who return, those who have returned to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala interview our hearts together and provide us and the rest of humanity with the sustained peace. Ameen.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. Good afternoon. I had to let Rachel, she's my boss, so that she could have given the perspective for the community. Brother Hussein Samatar is a community that had marched distinction, compassion, and effectiveness. He devoted his career to the public good, improving our district's education system in countless and enduring ways, sharing his passion for the one thing our children need to be successful in life, a world-class education, a well-rounded education. He believed every child, regardless of race, ethnic origin, cultural background, primary language, socioeconomic status, disability, or gender, can learn and must learn. Dr. Samatar will be counted as one of our truly great elected leaders. He had real motivation to make a really positive impact. In his private nonprofit career, Hussein devoted his education and talent to build the socioeconomic status of underserved communities. And we all know enduring poverty is the number one enemy for school success. His leadership style emphasized fair consideration of differing points of view and profound good faith in pursuing the public good with extraordinary effectiveness. I think the best way to describe him is we lost one of the pillars of the community, who is going to be a very difficult one to replace. His presence is still with us and will continue to be with us in memories and dreams. He leaves an amazing legacy to aspire and to be proud of. As we grieve, we pray for his wife, Uwa, and their children. May Allah give them the courage, strength, and consolation during this difficult time. May Allah the Almighty bless the soul of Marhum Hussein Samatar. Ameen.
Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. My name is Ilhan Omar. And we were given the task of speaking on the part of Hussein's purpose when it came to uniting the Somali and the African American community. Hussein Samatar approached community building in a holistic way. He always looked at a community in a broader aspect. So he looked at the family and the neighbor. To Hussein, having this reconciling the Somali identity and the African American identity was something that he struggled with, and I think most of us who are African immigrants struggle with. Hussein would always say, you know, that we are Somalis, but we don't want to be limited in that because we have, you know, the we are African Americans here, we are of African descent, like the other African Americans here, and that we don't want to be boxed in because our mobility and the kind of things that we can advocate for will be limited if that is the way that we choose to identify ourselves. Hussein understood three things, that it was important to have financial literacy, that it was important to have educational stability, and that the struggles that the African Americans have gone thus far was something that we needed to appreciate. That if you did not appreciate those that have gone through the struggles to pave the way for you, that you could not appreciate the opportunities that you would be grateful. And I think those are the kind of messages that he installed in his children, he installed in those that he mentored. Another big thing I think that that brought Hussein and I very close was his advocacy for getting our community, the next generation, to be politically involved. He said that it was really important for us new immigrants to make a difference here, and to see the fruits of the successes that we can have is to have political. He said it was really important that in power that numbers mattered, and that having the coalition between the African Americans and the Somali community would give us the strength to fight, the strength to advocate, and the strength to see our dreams come true. He understood that collaborative work with other minorities was essential in advocating for education and economic development. Like many of you, I was inspired by Hussein. And I hope that we can continue his legacy and remind the future generations of the amazing contribution that Hussein made to the lives of immigrant communities and to the communities at large in this beautiful city that we live in. I was in the hospital a few minutes ago, the same hospital that Hussein passed, and I was talking to the same nurses who are caring for my grandfather that cared for Hussein. And I said, I have to leave. I really didn't want to, but I had to leave. And they said, what's urgent? And I said, oh, we're going to be speaking about Hussein Samatar. And they said, he was an amazing person. When you go there, tell them that even in the difficult times, no matter what the decision was, no matter what the pain he felt, he always had an amazing smile. And of all of the patients that they've seen, they have not come across anyone that was so pleasant to be around, even in those kind of times. And that touched my heart, because I think most of us, even if we look at his picture, most of us remember Hussein's smile. And that's the one thing that I'll miss. And I think that's the one thing that we should all keep close to our heart. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My condolences. And, you know, this last week has also been very difficult for me. I am Shonda Smith-Baker. I'm the CEO of Pillsbury United Communities. I'm also the co-chair of the African American Leadership Forum. And in the last couple of weeks, there's been so many meetings that I've been invited to, or things that I've been asked, and they said, well, who else would you want to present with you? And I keep thinking, Hussein, who else? I'll be on the radio next week talking about the African-American community and what can we do to bring ourselves together more deeply. And it brought up a couple of things for me, a few memories. One is when I ran for school board in 2010, and there was, it was quite a race. And one of the issues that came up was that if I didn't make it or T. Williams didn't make it, there wouldn't be an African American on the school board. And I remember Hussein coming to me and saying, I'm African American, I can represent, that we have to move ourselves out of this box. And I remember struggling with that for a while. We would go back and forth, and I got it. I got what he was saying. I stand before you today on the eve of going to a meeting out in Portland to talk about how do we build coalitions. And Hussein used to say to me, your struggle, your community's struggle matters. It matters to my community. As we struggle, we need to be certain to listen to each other, to build the coalitions we need to build in order to make the city better. And there's so many examples, and it's often very sad to think about. Sometimes you don't recognize what someone means until later. And in this case, and I've said, Hussein is gonna be the gift that keeps giving this to the city, that we're gonna be in situations and circumstances, and we're gonna really think about what were some of the very forward-thinking, the courageous, the out-of-the-box messages that were coming forward that maybe in our own leadership maturity, maybe in the maturity of this city, we weren't ready to hear. But I'm almost willing to guarantee that we will be feeling the impact of his legacy for many years to come. Hussein Samatar was the first elected Somali in Minnesota. I hope that that legacy will move many of you in this room to run for office, to seek office, to lead his example. It's not often easy to be the first, but you have an amazing example, amazing person to run after. And I am so grateful to be here and appreciate the honor. Thank you.
Al Flowers, and I want to say loyalty. What Hussein was all about, he was loyal. He was a loyal person. And he got it. I advocate on behalf of African American kids all the time, but from the first day he got it. He knew that for a community like the African American community, we struggle. And I went over and met with him at the development center and seen how great he had made economics come to the Somali community. And I was amazed by what he had done in such a short time. And I always wanted to see how we can get there. And we always talked about how we can do it all over in the African American community. So, and he was just loyal, and he got about the culture that we had. We have to stand up. We have to be accountable in all communities, and particularly the African American communities. I keep saying it's no one's fault. We have to take the mantle to, if we want to be successful, each community know what their community needs. They have to be successful, and he was with me all the way. It was a big loss to the African American community. I heard what Shonda Smith Baker said. There was questions about, well, who's going to represent African Americans if those people hadn't got on the board. From day one, he represented the Somali community and the African American community, and I miss him. I miss him a whole lot already, because I knew he was in our corner for us to stand up and be self-sufficient for ourselves and our community. And I know, Mayor Ratback said out the box a little bit. In 2009, I tried to challenge the mayor, and I got knocked around pretty good. And Samatar had his tag on. He had his tag on. I said, you got to take that off, man. I'm running. You got to take that off. And he smiled. No, Al. No, I can't do that. So I know what the mayor's saying is about him and their relationship. He told that to me about that relationship. But but when he got through, we hugged and kissed, and he did it three times. I said, what's the third one for? And he was talking about love. That's love. So I learned, that's the way we greeted each other. So it was a great thing. But I know one thing, Hussein Samatar died around Dr. King's birth, a 50-year anniversary. He died at a history moment in time. It was a week we was having rallies all over the country and marches all over the country to celebrate 50 years of Dr. Martin Luther King, I Had a Dream speech. So when I got the news from my friend Behe, who we worked together on family unity, uniting all African communities with the African Americans, we are working on it right now. We are working on it, working hard to bring us all together, because our issues are not that far apart. We are trying to bring that together. When I just want the family to know that he died on somebody in some greatness of a 50-year anniversary. And it was an honor to be at his funeral, to be there, to be able to put dirt on him, to be able to be there and watch a Muslim funeral. I had never seen that, so he educated me on that there. And the biggest honor was when meeting his wife, well, I've seen her before, but to meet her and give my condolences from the African-American community, and I mean the Minneapolis Urban League and all the rest of the organization. I was coming and speaking on our behalf and our love for Hussein Samatar. And it's a big loss to us, but I would like us to keep working together as communities to establish what he was trying to establish in economics and particularly in our kids' education. So I thank you for your husband. He's up there, I would say, with Dr. King now, and they're probably looking down on him. So I thank you again.
You heard a lot about the person Hussein, his values. And next, we'd like to have Carla-based Tracy Nasbury and Muhammad come forward to talk about the power of Hussein.
Good afternoon. I work at the University of Minnesota, and today is our first day of class. And last week, Minneapolis Public Schools started our new school year. And this time is so busy and so all over the place that it was pretty incredible that on the first day of school, so many of us were together to reflect on Director Samatar's life. And I just really appreciated so much being able to then come back today too and spend some time, because it just seems like our society, it just seems to gobble up people and events, and we rush through the news cycles and we rush from tragedies to celebrations to another news cycle. And to take a moment today and participate in this memorial for Director Samatar is very, very meaningful to me. For Hussein took the time to remark on what mattered. As a person and a leader, he was able to stop and help make meaning often from the chaos and the conflict of every day. And as a member and then chair of the Finance Committee, Hussein was a very strong supporter of making sure that the money that the district was given was going to help the students, all students, in Minneapolis Public Schools. And as a member of the Finance Committee and the chair, he was a strong supporter of when we reviewed our banking practices. He encouraged the district to serve as a force for good for the entire community. And he took his role as an elected official of one of the major economic engines, which is the school district in this city. He took it very, very seriously. Hussein remained frustrated with how unclear education financing is. He remained frustrated for a long time with that, and he would continue to insist on the district developing clear and understandable financial documents for the public at large. That is so important. Hussein understood that a budget was a picture in numbers of the values of an organization. And he and I agreed absolutely on the importance of a more equitable and transparent budgeting process in Minneapolis Public Schools. And that work will continue. I learned so much from Hussein in our short but very intense time together on the school board, and I have been grieving his loss. My prayers and wishes are with his family and our community as a whole. So, as-salamu alaykum.
As-salamu alaykum. To know Hussein Samatar is to know that the power that sustained his commitment as a husband, father, brother, and friend was also the same power at the foundation of his work as an elected official. The power is Hussein's unwavering love. I believe that it is this love that was profoundly political and created the platform for Hussein to challenge us in three areas of transparency. First, a desire for transparency in the information shared with our stakeholders. Hussein will forever be remembered for his relentless questioning to ensure that information for our stakeholders was understandable, available, and relatable. He would often ask, what is the disaggregated data? What does this work do, and how does it support the vision of Minneapolis Public Schools? And what do you need to lead, Superintendent Johnson? A commitment to share information with stakeholders. This is the legacy of Hussein Samatar. Next, the desire for transparency continues in a clear commitment to his constituency. Hussein's views were not always popular. However, I would dare say that those who may not have agreed with him or his methods were certain that his reasons were out of love for the people that counted on him to stand in the gap. In a 2011 article by Beth Hawkins regarding the controversy of education and agendas and alliances, Hussein paved his own way. He states, "We are elected by the people of the city of Minneapolis to do our best in setting the best possible policies for the district. In signing this letter under the MFT logo, I felt I was asked to abandon my constituency, and I don't think any of us want to do that." The commitment to his constituency is the legacy of Hussein Samatar. Last, the desire for transparency was a demand for excellence. I believe this love had the audacity to demand the same level of excellence at every one of our Minneapolis public schools from north to south. We saw an example of this demand at the press conference called at the Somali Senior Program Center after the South High cafeteria incident. We saw this in his single vote, even when he stood alone. My hope is that we will still see it in a continued demand for excellence, because this is the legacy of Hussein Samatar. Uba, Hunan, Harun, Hebe, thank you for sharing your husband and your father with us. We will continue his legacy. Thank you.
As-salamu alaykum. I will try my best to hold myself. Hussein Samatar, a young, energetic leader who has a great voice of improving the education of all ELL students. He was a keen advocate for the rights and the needs of ELL students within Minneapolis Public Schools District, and also had a vision to reach beyond the scope of the board of directors, and was single-handedly willing to engage the legislative process in this of the state of Minnesota. Director Samatar, was instrumental in numerous initiatives throughout the Minneapolis district. He both advocated for and assisted the development of Somali heritage language and culture class in South Island. He also helped to establish, provide ongoing support of NABD centers at Sullivan School. The program served the needs of the newcomers, families by accelerating the learning process for Somali children in grade 3 to 8, in addition. He was, during the Director Samatar's tenure, that Minneapolis Public Schools began to collect data specifically in English language learners. The result, which is now available for 4 languages, English, Somali, Spanish, and Hmong. Apart from the success of Director Samatar's dream was to bring the Somali language teaching to the classes, to all the schools that the Somali students attend within the district. Luckily, with the support of Minneapolis Public School Superintendent and the board of Minneapolis Public School, he did succeed in establishing Somali language course at South High. Although throughout of his unwavering efforts, Director Samatar advocated on behalf of ELL students in a rural voice in order to maintain the level of attention that these students owe to receive. Furthermore, Director Samatar was a highly principled individual who never strayed from his state purpose. He never voted for any bill at the board that did not state clearly vision with ELL students. Director Samatar also never abstained for participating. He always either vote yes for what he felt was correct, or progressively no for the motion that he knew would not help the ELL students. One of the days on the board, he texted me and he said, "Did you read anything? Did anything pass at me that they're talking about the ELL and the proposal of the money?" And I said, "I didn't see it." So he said, "No." All the time. Dr. Samatar was a great friend of me and all of you. He told me that he admired to stay, especially the last days he told me that he was a good friend of Superintendent Johnson. Positively he told me that he was a friend. And I believe that he was a great friend to those who are here today. Allah, again, I'm thrilled and honored to stand in front of you for a few little words about the Director Samatar's meant so many. On behalf of the Somali community, it's our gratitude and thanks to the Board of the Directors of Minneapolis Public Schools and the Superintendent, what you have done the time he was seriously sick and when he died. One of these staff who lost his voice working hard, I don't see, I'm standing over there. Sam Allen, I talked to him at the funeral, and he didn't even say a word. He was throwing hands and said, "What do you say?" I said, "I cannot talk." Thank you very much. And those who are from Minneapolis Public Schools, you showed to this community that you meant a lot. Thank you very much.
Next, I'd like to invite up Kim Ellison and Richard Manor.
Good afternoon. Buongiorno. Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Bonjour. Buenas tardes. Hussein was still struggling with Spanish. But the fact that this man took the time to learn five languages really speaks about his curiosity of community and life. I was asked to say briefly what his loss means to the board. And first of all, I agree with everything that's been said of his loyalty, his wisdom, his courageousness, his vision, his values, all those things have meant so much to us. But I personally will miss his French. I had the great honor of running for office with Hussein and four other people in addition to Mohammed Noor and Shana Smith Baker. And I can tell you that the fact that Hussein was in that race and actually working with us made us all better people. He brought a dignity, an honesty, and made this job seem very, very important. I, like the mayor, had great beliefs that Hussein would survive this illness and come back and thrive. When I met with him in early July at the hospital, Cuba, and it was clear to me that he had the optimism, he had the hope. He had that smile, he had the claim that he could get past anything, and that his mission was that strong that he would carry that through. And I think that he is carrying that through all. So what I'd like to say, I will miss the many, many hours of spending time with him on the phone, discussing everything from football and why his son really wanted to play that game, to whether or not he should run for the state senate or the mayor's race, or just what this all meant. And we had a great time working through that together. We agreed to disagree in a number of areas to make a bigger point sometimes, because we knew that the conversation had to continue about public education. I'll miss that friendship, I'll miss that partnership. So thank you very, very much for sharing. And thank you very much for sharing him and for supporting him as a friend through all these years. We'll all benefit from it. Kim?
Say that you can help continue Hussein's legacy by leaving a note card. They are in the lobby. There's a table out in the lobby where you can write just a personal story or a feeling you have about Hussein. They will be delivered to his family at the end of this program. So we ask that you make sure you stop and do that. Also, if you, like I, have thought of a million stories that you have about Hussein, you come up here and deliver them like the great speakers already have. We will be videotaping stories that you want to say about Hussein, the messages that you want to leave for his family in the fishbowl, which is the hall, all the way at the end of the hall in the last room. And so please, at the end of this program, if you could stop by and videotape your story about Hussein. Thank you.
Next, I'd like to ask our chair and vice chair, Alberto Mazzarotta, who's the chair, and Jimmy Armstrong, vice chair of the board, to come forward.
Good afternoon. I met Hussein Samatar. Over the last few years, our work ran into each other. as we both were involved in economic development with immigrant communities. But I got to know Hussein Samatar better when we ran for the school board in 2010. But I think the way I would like to remember Hussein is probably the best meeting that we ever had. It was right after we had gotten elected to the school board. And we got together to plan ahead one-on-one. And although Hussein and me had grown up thousands of miles from each other, we shared that we had both grown up somewhere else. We had both spoken a language other than English at home. And when we got together, I remember sharing with him how we both were a little overwhelmed by the media attention that our election had gotten. The fact that he was the first Somali-born elected, and I was the first Latino elected to the board. I remember talking to him, and he said, "We don't know we should be celebrating that, or we should be concerned that this took so long." And also, how so much attention was given to that, but so little attention was given to the fact that we also shared strong financial backgrounds, that we also shared an entrepreneurial background, that started organizations in our communities, and how, because of where we came from, the focus really was where we were originally. The reason I chose to remember that meeting is because of the excitement that we had. We both were very excited about advocating for families that we felt had been disenfranchised in the past. And Hussein Samatar had a big passion for all families in Minneapolis. I know we've talked about some families, but he shared a deep love for all families, especially those that have been underserved, especially those who have been disenfranchised. So it's that excitement that we had and that I don't want to forget, because we were talking about everything that we could do. We shared also, worked together on setting ELL commission together. But I think there's been a lot of things that have been said about Hussein today. I choose to remember him, and I hope we can all remember him for one quality that sometimes was a little bit frustrating for some, but it was his impatience. I want everybody to remember his impatience for equity in education, his impatience for increasing achievement for all kids, and I hope that as we move forward, we don't forget that impatience. In education, we're always told, or when you're in elected office, you gotta be patient, you gotta wait. Well, I hope that we remember that we don't have time, and that we remember his impatience. We have a tradition in Minneapolis Public Schools. Whenever a school board member leaves the board, we present what we call a doorknob plaque. We usually present this at the end of somebody's term. We usually present it in person. Unfortunately, today we don't get to do that. We'd like to have his family join us so we could present this plaque. Thank you for having let us, thank you for having shared Hussein with us. For all the hard work, dedication, compassion, and love that Hussein offered and demonstrated through his work, and for the community and the thousands of children of our schools, we honor your family with this plaque on behalf of the Board of Education of Minneapolis Public Schools. Thank you for sharing his life and work with us. You will be deeply missed. If you'd like to support the Samatar family with a contribution, you can make a donation with a personal check, money order, or cash designated to the Hussein Samatar Memorial Fund. You can drop off your donation at the welcome table towards the entrance of the assembly room. You can also drop off your contribution at any Bremer Bank location. Thank you for helping us honor Hussein's work. We hope to continue to build on his legacy through our collective efforts.
And Again, we want to thank you all for being in attendance today, and I know that there are a lot of public officials that are here, and we want to thank you for coming out, and thank you for acknowledging and offering your condolences to the family and to the MPS family, because he was our family member as well. We probably spent more time with him than he got to spend with his family, actually. And there was one more person who the family wanted to say a couple of words for 2 minutes. Nasibu Sarveya.
I don't know, it's that. I think I'll start by thanking Superintendent for making this program better. One of unique features of Hussein Samatar, or one of the things that I've learned from him, was he actually told me that if something is not right, speak it out. So for that, I'd like to say thanks to, I know this was, this is a Minneapolis public school event, but I would tell you right away, for anybody who knows Hussein really well, Hussein will not appreciate it if an ABC member of the family would not have given a chance to speak. The reason why I say that, I know he has left a lot of legacies, and we know for the fact that one of them is an establishment of ABC, and hopefully, as he has strived for excellency, hopefully we'll be able to protect what he has started. We have lost an inspirational leader. I have lost a brother, a friend, and a great boss. I'm gonna do something that is, I know Superintendent may not like it, I know we don't have a lot of time. If we can have just, I wanna stop right here, I'm still emotional. If we can have just 1 second, please. If we can have the longest serving staff to speak for just 1 second, I'll really appreciate, and I'll stop right away. Stephen, my brother, please, if you can have just 2 seconds to say something about Hussein.
Since Hussein's passing, I thought I wouldn't be in a position like this to talk about him. I posted on Facebook a few days ago that Hussein is not dead. As long as we continue to speak his name, he's still alive. Right. And those things he told us, the values we share with him remain. We have a tattoo on our shoulder that's heavy. I first met Hussein in 2004 as a community organizer, trying to establish what we call a roundtable of African immigrant leaders with different aspects on my agenda: education, immigration, economic development. I called him on the phone and his voice was so gracious. So I have to meet this guy after meeting 20 or 30 other leaders, and I met him. So what do you have? Let's talk. He's so gracious. He shakes your hand, he pats you on the back. It's like, is this a brother that I've never known before? Where has he been all these years? And then we sit and talk for hours, the first time for hours. By the end of the day, he calls back to say, I think we need to meet again. I come back to his office, he has a contract. He said, we need you as our outreach coordinator. We want you to start acting now. We want to celebrate our first anniversary and do a number of things. He was a friend. He was great. He had a mighty, somebody said a word there, impatience. He always told me, Steve, don't depend on tomorrow. There's nothing like tomorrow. If we have anything to do, let's do it now. He was careful in planning, very meticulous. If you met Hussein today, you want to meet him again. Throughout most of my life, I was a human rights activist, talking for those who won't talk for themselves. In Africa, even here, try to do the same. He told me, Steve, you'll be wrong if you talk for everybody. He said, communities that are poor are never valued. Our task is to uplift our community. We're in a new country now. If our people can begin to develop real estate, own land, own property in this country, they'll be respected. Their own businesses, understand the economic structure of this nation and be able to navigate it, they'll be more respected. They'll move from a situation of beggarship to ownership. And that has been my journey with him since 2004. At this moment and the rest of my life, I always know that he's somewhere. Imagine if someone, as Hussein, was just for a moment out of this room and listening to what we're saying, and he came back and said, here I am. Imagine how more dedicated he would be in his work, knowing that people appreciated the things that he did. I think he would be greater than any of us ever thought. All of us are going to wear our shoes and tighten our belts and work to ensure that those values that he stood for, that we've all expressed here today, will live on, and our communities can be better because of him. I thank you.
This concludes our program and part of our gathering, and I want to encourage you all to take the opportunity to stay and write a card for the family. As I said, the cards are outside, and as well as the fishbowl, what we call the fishbowl is the last room straight down the hallway. I have to say that I've had many conversations with Hussein Samatar, and sometimes I call him Samatar Hussein, but you think with a name like Bernadia, I wouldn't get it wrong. And there were conversations about people who didn't have a voice, how me as a superintendent make sure I was leading and making sure that I was recognizing the needs of all students in the Minneapolis public schools. And I think that was his challenge to me and to all of us to continue to work hard on behalf of all children. I'm glad you said that, Director Maserati, because yes, he cared about black and brown students, but he cared about all students and felt like the equity was really, truly important to him. And I will surely miss him. And little did I know that the last few conversations I had with him would be the last ones, and we emailed each other a couple of times, and he stayed hopeful and he stayed optimistic. And he invited me and Director Az to be the match breakfast event that I went to, because you feel like you can't do anything to help. And so I asked, what is it I can do to help? And so after going to that event, we came back and hosted an event here, a Be the Match event here at the Minneapolis Public Schools. And it was my way of trying to help others who were similarly situated like Hussein, who needed that support. And we will be doing that annually at the here at the Davis Center. One of our last conversations, as you know, that this has been a lot of, I don't name it for you, but I think it's been challenging for the family on a number of levels. Uba has been, you know, with its children, trying to raise them and keep them focused, and also grieving their father. And one of the last conversations I had with Hussein was about the support that family would need after, you know, I don't think he knew he was passing, but it was just more about the financial need that they would have. And so I want to thank my friend Pam Costain for helping me set up an account at Bremer Bank, where people, if you feel like you can give, I think the family would greatly appreciate it if you would drop a check off in the basket here. We will make sure it gets deposited in the bank and notify you that it was done. Or if you can stop by our Bremer Bank, I don't know where they are located, just to support the family, we'll really appreciate that. I also have a proclamation here from the mayor of Minneapolis. I thought he was going to read, I think he left, that I just feel like I should read because proclamations are a big deal. There's a proclamation, whereas the long road from Somalia to Minnesota has transformed both places, and whereas one young man who took that path was Hussein Samatar,
learned English and much more from the books and librarians at the Franklin Library, whereas Hussein thrived in career in banking at Wells Fargo but left to help others, and whereas Hussein started the African Development Center, which provided financing and advice for many of the vibrant businesses in Minneapolis owned by entrepreneurs of African descent, and whereas Hussein partnered with the city of Minneapolis to develop a creative loan stride, more than 60 small businesses owned by Muslim immigrants get financing, and whereas Hussein gave hundreds of hours of volunteer time on numerous boards, including the Minneapolis Library Board and the Minneapolis School Board, and whereas Hussein's role as a successful business person, mentor, and the first Somali-born elected official in the United States has inspired scores more to follow his path. Now, therefore, IRT Ryback, Mayor of the City of Minneapolis, do hereby proclaim September 3rd, 2013 as Hussein Samatar Day in the City of Minneapolis. The mayor of Minneapolis. His son's request to say a few words.
Every day when I woke up, I didn't call him Hussein, I didn't call him Mr. Samatar, I called him my father. He was my dad, my father. When he woke up at 5 o'clock, I go to school, I wake up at 6. He was on his computer, he told me to get dressed, but when I left him to go to school, he told me be a leader, learn, and listen, three L's. Because without education, you will never go anywhere in life. And that's what I say to everyone, because without education, my dad would not have left Somalia. He would never be here, and who is today. Thank you.
I want to say thank you very much for what you did. I don't know, all of you know Hussein a little bit, but I know him 19 years. Before 19 years, I only know him 4 months. I don't know how that happened. I said I do. In that 19 years, he was alive. I have 4 blessed kids. Alhamdulillah, thank you very much for your support. Please, the contribution you do. Hussein was telling me that he was only out 8 days from the hospital. One day he said, you know, I promised that I will build a hospital somewhere in Somalia. And you know, women have give birth and they die so much. 5 out of, I think, I don't have the percentage in my head. So whatever contribution you do, it's a hospital in Somalia somewhere. That only for women, for men.
Again, this ends the program, and we want to thank you all for coming out. And don't forget to write a card, drop off at the gift basket, or do a video. And we'll be advertising next to the match.
Waxaan si gaar ugu mahadcelinaynaa guddoonka waxbarashada dugsiga dadweynaha Minneapolis, kormeere guud Dr. Benedia Johnson, duqa magaalada Minneapolis R.T. Rayback, Chief Minneapolis ADC Alfred Daly, iyo guud ahaan asxaabta, qaraabada iyo saaxiibada kala duwan ee iyagu waqtigoodii iyo u soo huray sidii ay noogala qayb qaadan lahaayeen madasha xuska taariikh nuraadka marxuum Hussein Samatar. Ilaahay waxaan uga rajeynaynaa Hussein Samatar inuu jannada raxma siiyo ubadkiisa, afadiisa, asxaabtiisa, caa'idadiisa iyo cashiiradiisana uu samad iyo iimaan u ka siiyo. Assalaamu calaykum waraxmatullaahi wabarakaatuh.